Mark chapter 4, verse 35 to 41. And the same day, somebody shout the same day. When the even was come, he said unto them, let us pass over unto the other side. And when they had sent away the multitude, they took him, even as he was in the ship. And there were also with him other little ships. And there arose a great storm of wind, and the waves beat into the ship so that it was full. And he was in the hinder part of the ship, asleep on the pillow. And they awake him and say unto him, Master, carest thou not that we perish? And he arose and rebuked the wind and said unto the sea, peace, be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. And he said unto them, why are ye so fearful? How is it that ye have no faith? They feared exceedingly and said one to another, what manner of man is this? Even the wind and the sea obey him. I want to share tonight this session briefly on victory over the storms of life. Victory over the storms of life. How to enjoy victory over the storms of life. Life has two sides. He said, let us go over to the other side. So there is another side of life. You may have been a victim on one side, but there is another side. Where there is a side of poverty and there is a side of abundance. There is a side where you spend life diseased, and there is a side you spend life in good health. There is a side where you are deprived, the side of deprivation, and there is a side of plenty and abundance. Maybe you have been on one side of life all these years. You have not known what it means to enjoy the other side, but by the power of God, you are stepping into another side of life. You are stepping into another side of wealth. You are stepping into another side of prosperity. You are stepping to another side of deliverance. You are stepping to another side of favor. I say you are stepping to another side. I say you are stepping to another side. Maritally, it's another side. In ministry, it's another side. Somebody say, it's another side. But Jesus said, let us go. To go to another side, you can't go alone. Let us go. To move to another side, you've got to move with God. Ladies and gentlemen, he said, let us go. Meaning, when a man has God with him, he can't be on one spot for too long. What you will hear in your marriage from now is let us go. What you will hear in business now is let us go. What you will hear in your finances is let us go. Where are you going? The place of your rest. Where are you going? The place of greatness. Where are you going? The place of destiny. I see God going with you. I see God going with you. I see God going with you. Somebody say, Lord, go with me.
Go with me.
Now, please, take your seat. The Bible says, and he sent the multitudes away and told the disciples, let's go. Now, ladies and gentlemen, when I read that he sent the multitude away, I felt Jesus was not sympathetic. The multitude came to hear the word. Why send them away? God has no business for unserious people. He sent them away. In other words, whatever happens to you is your business. God has no plan for unserious people. If you toil with God, you become a toy. Are you a disciple or are you a multitude? Only disciples experience another side. Multitudes. God has no agenda for them. That sounds harsh, but it's the truth. If you refuse to grow, you're on your own. Those who grow, go. Those who don't grow, groan. Those who grow, they go. But those who refuse to grow, they groan. Now, the place we read, the Bible says something. It's, now, this is when I read this, the Lord told me to read it again. I read it. He said, Jesus was in a sheep and there were people in a smaller sheep. They put Jesus, his disciples put him in a big sheep and allowed the others to go in a small sheep. Jesus, well, they put him, he didn't on his own. The Bible said they took him and put him in a big ship. When you give God reference, it makes you a preference. They didn't put him in a small one, they put him in a big ship. How you handle God is how God handles you. They put others in a smaller ship, but they put Jesus in a bigger ship. Ladies and gentlemen, you must make up your mind in 2015 that you've got to give God reference so that he can give you preference. You can't joke with God. God is too big for you to give certain offering. God is too big for you to toil with. God is... How can I spend, for example, ₦1 million on a trip to London, on a trip to Dubai, wasted, and yet you can't give God half of that? There are people that can buy a pair of shoes, $20,000. But yet, they can't give God $20,000. Am I talking to somebody here? You must settle down and ask yourself questions. How can somebody who has gold, I mean jewelry is worth $3 million, $4 million, and yet you don't, God, that kind of amount is not credited to your account in the kingdom. On the day of trouble, you will call on your gold. They put others on a smaller ship and they put him on a bigger ship. This is what God told me. He said there are people who have put him on a smaller ship. Meanwhile, they are in a bigger ship. Am I communicating? I saw a young man who said to me, he's building a house. I said, you are building a house? He said, yeah. And he showed me it was a massive estate. And it's one bag of cement. It's not in God's house. Don't just leave them alone. Champions are changing every day. It doesn't matter. Anybody who is playing with God now, no problem. Champions are changing. Overtaking is allowed. This world have no respect for former champions. Am I talking to somebody here? Champions are emerging every day. The richest before are no more the richest. Why? Because preference. A man, late M.K. Abiola was in a mosque and the imam was asking for an offering. And he said they should tell the man to forget about it and they should come and collect the money at the end of the prayer time. And at the end, the man began to pray for him. He said, no witch, no wizard will eat your money. No, he said, let them come. They will eat and tire. He said, let witches come and eat money. They will eat and eat and be tired. Why? He said, this is what I did in the first place to get it. When you make God, you reference him, he make you a preference, he make you a choice. Am I talking to somebody? He said you become an eternal excellency, a hope for many generations. There are some of you, nations will feed from your hand. I said nations will feed from your hand. Generations will eat from your pocket. I said generations will eat from your pocket. I am talking to someone here. Grace is about to speak for your life. Lift your hands and shout, yes!
Take your seat.
The storms of life are necessary because they reveal a new dimension of God. Anytime you are going through a storm in life, it means there is a dimension of God that is about to be unveiled. Can I shock you? Hold on. Look at me. Why were the disciples shocked? The same Jesus They saw him minister, blind saw, lame walk. You should be able to know that this man can do anything. No, as far as they were concerned, he only had power over sickness, not nature. So when they saw him, he spoke to this and said, not only leprosy, not only blind, even the sea, there's a dimension of God. That means even if nature wants to walk against you, you can walk against nature. Am I talking to somebody here? You can change nature. I say you can change nature. There are certain things that want to happen, and people say, don't bother, it is nature. If you don't like it, change it. I say you don't like it, change it. I am yet to tell you, don't bother when you go through shaking. It is because there is a side of God that is about to be revealed. When it appears you are going through barrenness, there is a side of God that is about to be revealed. You are going through disappointment, there is a side of God that is about to be revealed. You are going through poverty, there is a side of God that is about to be revealed. Ministry appears shaking, there is a side of God that is about to be revealed. Someone broke your heart, there is a side of God that is about to be revealed. They denied you a visa, there is a side of God that is about to be revealed. Someone spread lies about you, there is a side of God that is about to be revealed. There is a bad news hanging, there is a side of God that is about to be revealed. There is a court case, there is a side of God that is about to be revealed. Maybe the landlord looked at you and sent you out of the house. There is a side of God that is about to be revealed. You don't serve a dead God, you serve a mighty God. He's the same yesterday, he's the same today, he's the same forever. When God say yes, no man can say no. When God lifts you up, no man can bring you down. God is on your side, power is on your side, glory is on your side, favor is on your side, grace is on your side. Somebody shout fire, yeah, 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 yeah. Shout yeah, shout yeah, shout yeah. Somebody shout yes, 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 yes.
Look at that.
Look at this. He went